Did you know a computer existed way back in World War II? This is a computer. The T-1, a bombsight. It was a warbird game changer for bombers like the British Canadian Halifax, Stirling, and Lancaster. Unlike earlier bombsights, the T-1A was gyro-stabilized, maintaining a stable aim point even when the aircraft was buffeted by turbulence. This mechanical computer integrated data like altitude, speed, and wind to continuously calculate a bomb's trajectory in real time. It was a crucial tool that minimized human error, giving bomber crews the best possible chance of a successful hit. The full story is next.
Hi everybody, Karl Kjarsgaard back with you here at Bomber Command Museum, and we're here in the Halifax Bomber Exhibit, and we're going to give you another great show, the Halifax 57 Rescue Show, and you're going to see a Bomb Aimers Special, this beautiful treasure to make the Bomb Aimers position of the Halifax Bomber, and we've got it for you, so let's head into the rebuild shop, and I'll show you all the goodies we've got. Okay, everybody, here we are in the rebuild shop of the Bomber Command Museum. And right next to me is one of the rarest nose cones you're ever going to see. This is for a Halifax Mark III. It's a beautiful 100% complete nose cone on the front of the Halifax. And I found it in a guy's garden east of London, England, and he was growing tomatoes. Wow. What I did was, I said, I'll trade you some bomber radios for the nose cone. And here it is, one of the rarest nose cones right here in Nanton at Bomber Command Museum. But that's not the magic. Now you see this window, this is where the bomb aimer looks straight down at the ground and does his bombs away. Now, I'm going to show you the magic tools of the bomb aimer of Bomber Command. And I'm talking about the bomb aimer of the Stirling bomber, the bomb aimer of the Lancaster bomber, and the bomb aimer of the Halifax all use this magic right here. And there it is, folks, 82 years old, brand new bomb sight computer, analog computer used to make a solution for the bomb aiming purpose of the bomber. And folks, there are beautiful inputs here that you just have to see. And I'll show you here is there is all your different inputs. There's altitude of the aircraft, heading of the aircraft, wind speed, terminal velocity of the type of bomb you're dropping, angles. You have to have the aircraft level when the bombs are dropped. This is the analog computer. And how new is it? How new? There's the original calibration letter from the factory. This was built in 1943. And myself and another gentleman were the first guys to pull it out of the original box just about 3 weeks ago. So this is the bomb sight computer for your heavy bomber. And there's the sighting head for the bomb aimer. So this, you put the raw data in here, analog computer, it works out the ballistics and the physics and the aiming solution for the bomb load of your bomber based on everything that they're experiencing at the time. And then that is sending a signal via cable to here, and you can't quite see it. There's a glass prism here, which is, and the image, the sighting solution, the drop solution is imprinted on that glass slide, and the bomb aimer would be hovering over this right there, looking out that window, and he would be able to get the exact instant bombs away. And remember, there is something you don't know about bomb aimers and pilots. When the pilot's bringing the airplane in on target, if he needs to make an adjustment to the left, the code call from the bomb aimer to the pilot is left, left. Two lefts. If he wants the pilot to go to the right, he only says right. One time. So in the din and the cacophony of explosions and all of the pyrotechnics and turbulence and everything, if the pilot hears net net over the intercom, because he can't hear a damn thing, he heard two commands to make an adjustment to the left. He knows it's left, left. Or if he hears one command, that means you gotta go to the right a bit. And once they have everything aced, once they have the computer has worked out a solution, it's projected the image onto the bomb aimer's bomb sight. He's looking out that window there. Then he has programmed, you see all these 15 switches? This is an interval meter that you set up the drop sequence of each bomb. You do not drop the bombs out, 117 bombs, all in one split second. You drop them out possibly in pairs. You drop the first two at the front out. Then you drop the last two at the back of the bomb bay out. You are doing a sequence so that the airplane doesn't go out of control and the center of gravity doesn't get sabotaged from a salvo drop, which is dangerous for a bomb run. But all of this is how the bomb aimers did it. And I wanted to show you that so you understood. We had that. That's great. We got that for the Halifax. We've got these, and these you can find. This, folks, you will not. You can look for 20 years and never find this. But we found it in its original box in Calgary since 1943. It's never been in an airplane. So guess what I'm doing? This little baby's going in the Halifax. So there's your bomb aimer's special presentation of how it works. I hope you enjoyed that. We've got more information for you. We've got all kinds of contact information. We've got our website. We've got our special fundraising site. But whatever you can afford to donate to us, we will find you more treasure. So stick with us. We leave no Halifax behind.